So, I updated my system. I had a Phenom 2X6 1090T that ran at 4 GHz for 9 years, I think. I got it right when it came out, and it finally died on me, and I wanted a new system. So, looking around on the internet, I decided I wanted the i7 8700 non-K, and I have turbo enabled, so it's running 4.3 GHz constantly. And a lot of people talk about the Hyper 212 Evo, saying that it's not good enough to even cool the non-K model. And I have the 212 Evo with some Artic Silver 5 in my system now, and the max temperature I have seen one core hit 75 C, and that was while encoding in handbrake for, I don't know, like 30 minutes or so. It's stable in prime, running 3000 megahertz on my RAM with the XMP profile. I'm running a XFX R9 290X that's old. I've beat the hell out of it over the years, but it still works. And I have all this crap on the screen because I was just trying to show what all I'm still running in the background. I don't turn any of this off. Let me stick all this crap back over here on my other monitor. But I'm actually really happy with the processor, and I got the MSI Gaming Plus. It was only $109 on Amazon, and everything's been running great. My temperatures are nice and low. I set a aggressive fan profile in the BIOS, so the fan reaches 100% if the processor hits 70 C. So everything's been running fine. I've got hardware monitor, rain meter, Steam, Discord, all this crap for my keyboard, mouse, and everything in the background. And I wanted to see, and couldn't find, a video of somebody running some of the older benchmarks, let alone just one video that showed all of the old benchmarks from like 2005 and up. I mean, I used to run one that was called P Test. I thought it was a funny name, but it had little jets flying around and stuff. Just old demos and tech demos and benchmarks and whatnot, so I figured I would do it. So I'm gonna start with the Ladybug AMD demo and work my way all the way up to the new 3D mark. So yeah, it's gonna be a long video, but you can fast forward around and stuff. Thank you. mic's really low, but everybody's asleep right now, and I still wanted to make this video. And another thing I forgot to mention is a lot of these older benchmarks, especially the old 3D marks, I don't think they play very well with hyper-threading and so many cores, because I definitely remember getting more frames per second in some of them. But that's something I figured I would mention. Anyway, let's run the mecha demo. This is the Stone Giant NVIDIA tech demo. Another fun one I used to run all the time. You have to hit enter to start the benchmark. I have to remind myself every time. And some of these were just a huge deal to me back in the day. Like, this is the first time I really paid attention to depth of field. This and the ladybug demo really started showing me depth of field and whatnot. It just looks awesome. I really gotta give props to people like Jay's Two Cents. I've heard him talk about how many times he had to like edit or redo something on a video. I kind of get it now, because I'm not doing any editing whatsoever, because I hate it, and I've been recording this for about 3 hours already, and it's only going to be like an hour and a half video, but I wanted to make it, and I don't want to edit, so I'm going to keep doing it this way. Done with the sanctuary benchmark, and it freezes, so I have to kill it in task manager. And redirect this screen. Tropics. Now to recognize this one. Lost count of how many times I have run these benchmarks years ago, and I still love them. codes correctly. Alright, what's up next? Of course, Heaven. As it came out next. Yeah, everything's maxed out. Thank you. that. Now, I kind of want to just do a medium run, but I'm gonna do a run without the anti-aliasing. Thank you. headset in because it cut off right in between starting up this, so not sure where the audio was, but whatever. I'm just gonna roll with it. I think I was saying that superposition here, I'm gonna run twice as well. You can fast forward back and forth, whatever. I'm gonna start with the 1080p extreme because I only have a 1080p monitor. Oh, and some of this would load a lot quicker, but I have this on a regular spin-up hard drive, and my SSD is not very big, but I'm pretty sure some texture pop-ins and loading times would be a lot better, but this is what I got. What I need is somebody to send me a 1080 Ti and a 1 TB SSD. Yeah. This one was scary once it hit the CPU test, but I'm going to run the whole test anyway. Made me think it was going to crash when it hit the CPU test while recording. Some good nostalgia though. Shout out to 3D Mark and Future Mark for all of the random TNA and the jiggle physics. They've always had a little bit of that in there for the guys. I don't even know if it even recorded all of that. Holy crap. Well. So. That's fun. And that was on the performance preset. The extreme, I just did not feel like waiting on it. It's ridiculous. But a little more nostalgia for you. And then, oof, here's where it gets fun. Now each test I have to run individually, and then I have to kill it in Task Manager. So, we're gonna start here. I don't know why I do this, but just for the hell of it, I can crank this and run. Man, I've ran these so many times. Oh my god. And the silo drops on the dude, and the box is blown off the shelf. If you start to get towards being an enthusiast with computers and tech stuff with like benchmarking and whatnot, every time a new benchmark comes out, you have to get it, you have to download it, you have to see how it runs, and then you tweak your system over and over again, just trying to see what you can get and how you can make it run. So, some people know what that's like. It's just funny how many times I've seen these. Where it's about to crash out. I don't think it really crashes so much as it just stalls. Then I have to kill it in Task Manager and go back in. These were the real throwback for me. I'm gonna do this every time. I remember my scores back in the day. I think one of the first times I ran this particular test was on an AMD Athlon 6000 Plus that I got to 3.8 gigahertz. I think I was running 1066 on my RAM and a 4870, and then I got to borrow another 4870 and run it Crossfire, and I was amazed. And now we crash out again in task. and skip the CPU test on this one too, because I remember they were crashing out too. So let's do this one, the Dragon in the Canyon. I love how the pilot just turns around like he don't give a fuck and just floors it at the end. There it goes. What? Peace. And we got one more run after we kill that. And then we can move on. Let's see. Yeah, I definitely remember this running way faster on the 4870X2. When I got the 5870 1GB, and then when I moved up to the iFinity 6 edition, definitely got more frames before, but still pretty great. Let's move on. Now, this one, I'm gonna run the basic, and I'm gonna run it on the extreme, and then I'm gonna run it on advanced, and just for the record, there's a random key that's been floating around. I saw it on YouTube, and I just punched it in to see if it would work, and the advanced does work. But you don't get official results or whatever, but I'm just going to run the performance mode to under advanced, just because I can. So now, down to the last round of tests. Alright, leave time spy for the end. Let's go here. I'm gonna run Ice Storm Extreme. For mobile devices. go. Yep. Graphics driver is not approved. Crap. Alright, so cloud gate. This one looks like complete crap, but I'm gonna run it anyway. Wouldn't be the first time. Won't be the last. Graphics driver not approved. Alright, oh, here we go. More of that TNA and jiggle physics. Thanks, 3D Mark. guess we're gonna move on to, holy shit, let's get ready for low frames. It's been a long video. It right now is 4:01 a.m. on the East Coast. Yeesh. I just wanted to do it though. Definitely gotta work on getting a better GPU, but this thing has been holding up for a long time. Long time. We'll be right back. testing. I guess, before I cut this video off, let me see. Maybe a desktop. Wait, no. Are you clicking more than one thing? Let's see, Cinebench real quick. You can see my old scores. I'll just go ahead and run CPU. And I just think it's cool that I just bought the parts, put it together, have not had to tweak anything or do anything crazy. Everything just works, and it works pretty damn well. Definitely running lower than before, but I have all these background processes and whatnot. Yeah, I'll save it for the hell of it. So, say I wanted to play a game. Pretty much any game that I own or have ran is, like, perfectly fine with ultra or a mix of medium to ultra settings. It just works. Here for half a second. It should load a little bit quicker because I'm on my SSD for this. This was on the low difficulty. Let's just continue. I went in here just to test some things out. I forgot, can you go to the settings once you're in-game? I don't remember if you can or not. Let me see. Settings, video, 1080p, 8 times on the anti-aliasing. Motion blur high, advance, yeah, I know. Ultra, everything is as high as it gets, 16 times anthroscopic. Sharpening amount I just left on 2.0, but yeah. All that wide open, and in a game, everything runs perfectly fine. Trying to think of a direction to go to run into some bad guys. I think that way. Maybe. I'm horrible with this map and with this game in general. The objective is that way, so go up here. Had I planned to do this, I have a save point. It's better than this. We want to go back that way, so through here. Yeah, is that where we're going? Yeah. Ah, crap. Well, I was trying to get into some action real quick. But yeah, it runs great. Access denied.
Yellow security clearance required.
Anyway, so games are great. Bunch of action and stuff going on in the background. Works perfectly fine. Let me see. Let me just start. Or no, I'll go here. It's already a long video, so might as well throw some extra crap in here. Nobody's gonna watch it anyway.
access points to the tower were destroyed in the explosion. The pipeline is damaged but still intact. There are thrust boots in the maintenance hangar. You can use them to reverse the pipeline.
Yeah, I'm supposed to go that way, this way. Where am I supposed to go? Just wanted to get in the middle of some action. Yeah, there we go.
Demonic presence at toxic level. Lockdown in effect.
Huh. Runs great. Love it. Gonna die. And I'm just showing it has no problem with anything I throw at it, even with the older video card. Love it. Alright, so exit.
Demon presence eliminated.
Pretty much anything I do on here. It just does it. I love it. So, if anybody's been thinking about upgrading, I would get the definite non-K, unless you just care about overclocking. That cooler is perfect for this thing, and really won't have any issues with anything that I can think of. One more thing. Let's go here. Go to air prime 95. I can't remember which one. Maximum maximum heat. We just turned that on and we are up to 73 74. Fans are kicked up pretty good now. And, she's stable. I have no problems. So, that's, pretty much it. I didn't plan very well for this. But I just wanted to show how everything works. And once that fan kicked in, these temps with Prime 95 going for hours will not go too long. Which, you see, it did throttle a little bit. But I haven't had anything else throttle this processor. So, at a real world usage, you're not going to have any problem with this processor and that 212 EVO at all. So, let me kill that out. And then, like I was, I've been messing around with handbrake, which is about the most really intensive thing that I have that, I've been messing with lately. We'll just go here. And here's a video that I need to encode. And, see, I've been putting it on medium. Leave that. Doesn't matter. Just desktop. Yeah. Start encode. And temperatures never go out of control. And you can see now it's stuck on 4.3. No throttling. So, real world usage, perfect. And the point of the whole video in the first place was all the benchmarks. I just threw this in here if anybody watches this far, which I doubt will happen, but yeah. In fact, I'll let this encoding pass get through. And that's a, how big is that file? Did I close it? Nope. That is a little under a half a gig file, and this is the file that's recording right now. That took about a minute and, I'll say a minute and 10 seconds for medium encoder preset, quality 22, on handbrake, 1080p, 30 frames per second. So yeah, it runs, and maybe somebody will see something out of this video that they wanted to. Alright, I'm going to set this video to encode and get a little sleep. Peace.